Good afternoon, student. How are you? I hope all of you are fine. So today again I came back with this exercise. Last day we already started this one, the work exercise 7, page number 27, and complete up to number 3. I give to you the homeworks from the number 4 and 5. So today we start from number 6. See the number 6 here is given that. Sorry, I give 4, so I start from number 5. So number 5 is the number of primary school teachers in 1978 was 12,87,499. And in the other year, 1986, that the number of primary school teachers increased that 15,30,150. Now, how many more teachers were there in 1986 than the 1978? So you have to understand, you have to find out the difference between the both the year, number of primary teachers. So first is the number of primary teachers in the year of, in the year of 1978 is that 12,87,499. Now, the other is the number of primary teacher in the year of 1986 is 15,30,150. They have to find out. So the number of primary teacher increased then first we write the bigger one 12,87,499. So you have to subtract because we have to find out the difference between these two years, the number of teachers. So we have to make the subtraction. First is the 1, 5, 6, 2, 4, and 2, 3. So 2. So 2,42,651. This number of teachers are increased in the primary teachers are increased in the year of 1986. So only you have to make the difference means a subtraction. You have to take. Then you have to complete this. I hope you have to understand this one. Now see the second one. That number 6 one. See the number 6 one. Number 6 is given. One truck that can carry 950 bags of cement. Now how many trucks are needed to carry that 85,500 bag of cement? Now first we have to write that the number of cement bag carry by one truck. That is the 950 bags. So 85,500 cement bag carry by number of trucks are 950. You have to divide with the 85,500. 950 9 85 50. 0 will come, 0 will go here. So we need the 90 trucks. 90 trucks we need to carry this amount of cement bags. So because we have to, here is given that how many trucks so we can get by this way, this is the answer. Now see that next one. Next one also, the total number of students in the classes of 10 and 11, 10 and 12, that in the all the schools of the state is the 43,52,324. Out of this number, 18,40,126 are girls.
Now, how many are boys? So, you have to find out. So, you have to make again the differentiate, or the girls number are given. So, you have to find out the boys number. So, that's why you have to do the subtraction here. And the last one also, the number of votes cast in the election was 3,43,140 from West Delhi and the constituency, and 12,63,290 from the New Delhi constituency, North Delhi, and 6,43,928 from the South Delhi, and the 15,72,821 from the East Delhi. So what is the total number of vote cast? Is the total, so you can understand, is the addition. So these two math, you have to do it. These two math is your homework. That's the number 7 and 8. It's very easy. Number 7 one is the subtraction between the two number, and number 8 is all the numbers you have to add. Then you get the answer. Now you see the exercise. What exercise 8? What exercise 8? That the page number 30. See here, it's given the simplify according to the DAMAS rule. DAMAS means the DMAS. D means divide. D means the division. Okay? And M means the multiplication. And A means the addition. A means the addition. And S means subtraction. Okay, these things you have to remember. So first, the division means the division work at first in the simplification. Next, the multiplication is the multiplication work or the multiply. Third is the addition work, and the last is the subtraction works. So this rule we have to follow while we are going to solve this math. Now see the first one. That the first is given number 1, A, 3 plus 2 multiply 6. Now we know the DAMAS rule, that first one divide, so division is not there. So after that multiplication, so multiplication is there, so we have to do the multiplication work first. This one, 2 into 6, how much? Is that 12? So 12 plus 3 is 15. Complete it. Now see the second one, number B, that 8 multiply 4 plus 9 divide 3. Now we know the rules. First is a division work, so division is there. So this one still remains same, no need to do anything. 9 divide 3. 9, 3, 3 ja 9. So if we divide, we get the answer 3. Now again, we know that next step is the multiplication. So this one, first this one, second this one. 8, 4 ja 32 plus 3. So the answer is 35. See the another one, number 3. Number C is 12 minus 10 divide 5 plus 7 multiply 3. Now first you know the division rule. So 12 minus, now you have to divide this one. 5, 2 ja 10. So 2, then plus multiplication time. So 7, 3 ja 21. Now again, these two, this one and this one is the plus, only this one minus. So you make it in one side. So 12 plus 21 minus 2. So 12 plus 21 means 20 plus 1, 30, 33. 33 minus 2, so it becomes 31. So by the way, you can do it this one also. And see the number D also. Number D is given, 21 divide 7 plus 16 minus 3 into 5. Now first the division rule, so 7 divided by 21, 7 3 ja 21 plus 16 minus 3 into 5. Now the next line, multiplication rule, so 3 plus 16 minus 3 5 ja 15. Now 3, now is the, now this third one is the addition rule. So 3 plus 16 is the 19 minus 15. So 19 minus 15 is the 4. So it means the answer. So I hope you have to understand. You have to follow always the DAMAS rule. Division, multiplication and addition and subtraction. If you follow one by one, you can solve it easily. Otherwise, you have to make mistake if you not follow these rules. So I hope you have to understand it and you complete. I already completed up to number D. You have to complete next 5 math. That E, F, G, H and I. Your homework is this from the exercise 8. That from E to I. That you have to complete it by your own. From the E to I. This number you have to complete it. Okay. So for today up to here. Next day we have to discuss this exercise, few left maths and another exercise. Thank you.